We are here on the Birmingham Spur area of the Delta Junction. We are standing next to the river call, the river diversion we've completed last year. And we are standing between the two river call east and west viaducts. The existing river call was actually clashing with four major structures that we are building here and three of the embankments. So in order to build the structures and the embankment, we've had to realign the river. We have the M42 South Viaduct, we have the two River Call East and West Viaducts, and we also have the manor drive, the existing road with the overbridge. In May 2024, last year, we started with the construction of the test channel. We had a long engagement with the Environment Agency in order to show them what we were going to build, which was basically just a little part of the final realignment, which was offline. It was also a good test for us, for the team, to see exactly what we're building, the different details of the riprap, core mitting and all these kind of things. So it was a really good start. So in June 2024, we started the realignment of the new channel. We also had to install two temporary bridges, which were both 43 meter long. Then complete installed the portable frame dam. So we had to install three portable frame dams in three different locations. Once we had all the test channel built, we started by flooding the test channel first upstream. So we had some temporary dam with a frame, and then we had a membrane on top of that. So by upstream and downstream, we had those dams in place. So we removed first the membrane to let the water flow from downstream upstream, to let the water find its way slowly into the channel and to see how the channel react to it, really. So that was the first one we did with the test channel. And then in September, we did the bigger part of the stream. So same idea, we started from downstream, removing the porta dam, removing just the membrane, letting the water flow into the channel. And then once all the water was in place, we then removed the porta dam on the upstream part. Before we remove any of the porta dam and before we removed any of the membrane, we've had a visit from the Environmental Agency. We've had a designer coming to site as well to make sure everything was in place and was built properly.
We had a specialist team of contractors in, which electrofished the channel, consented by the Environment Agency. And they did it in a phased approach. So start from sort of downstream end, put a cylinder in, electrofishing area, capture those fish, put them into buckets, aerate the water, and check them for health, measurements, count the species, and then place them back into a suitable location in the new river channel. Throughout the sort of the scheme, the design scheme, the construction, and then the evolution as this takes over time, we've got a number of areas. It's been designed to have multiple levels so that you have different flow amounts throughout time. We've placed sandbars, gravels. We've utilised some of the local trees from literally hundreds of metres away, and that's been placed within the riverbank and into the river to create stall points and riffles and allow the river to naturally evolve over time so that it can deposit gravels and create habitats for fish to breed and deadwood over time. To incorporate the built structures, the river realignment, we've also done an area of replacement flood storage. So within the project, we call it an RFS. That's linked to the river channel itself.
The replacement flood storage, it basically acts as a giant sink. If we end up with a large downpour of rain and a weather event that wouldn't be able to handle, the water will flow into the replacement flood storage area. It'll store there for a short amount of time, and then it will just seep back into the river and downstream over the following days, weeks and months.
So since we've completed the river realignment, we've evacuated the existing river, we've completed now the rigid inclusion, which are the ground improvements at all the by all the abutments of the viaducts here. So we have five areas. We've also completed a technical backfill on the northern side of the river called East and West Viaducts to be ready to connect the Greenland embankment, which will be finished this year as well.
We've increased the length of river in this area, and then we've created new embankments, new planting, which is improving the no net loss in this area and increasing the biodiversity of this area. And hopefully as we move forward into the future, we'll be able to, as the construction work stops, start to bring in people into this area. We will be working with the local borough councils to open this up underneath all of the viaducts through this area, creating footpaths and walkways. This diversion has helped us to bring in some of our really key indicator species along this area. This is a salmonoid river environment, so we've been able to work with the fisheries to improve things for those types of species. Throughout this period, there have been a huge number of technical jobs that have taken this idea all the way through. The diversity of jobs and the ability and the employment this has created is huge, and the skills I hope will be moved on into the future onto other parts of HS2 and then into the future onto other infrastructure projects in UK. So the next steps of this site are to blend and move to a position where we can start opening up this up to the local population as the construction work stops. And then I hope the people will start to feel what HS2 really will be, which is not just a railway, it's also a green corridor and also in areas, some really excellent areas that people and the public can start to use. I hope in 10 years' time to be able to bring my family here and show them what we've been able to create, an environment with a beautiful watercourse running through the middle of it, walkways to allow people to be able to access it safely, and also to show what HS2 has brought to this area.